over 50,000 people visit this old railroad tunnel near Rocheport, Missouri every year. But how many stop to actually look at and think about the details of the tunnel itself? For example, why is the portal on this side dressed stone, but that on the other side is bare rock? In a previous video, we discussed why this location became the only tunnel bored along a 900-mile rail line connecting St. Louis and Texas, now part of the 240-mile rail trail better known as Missouri's Katy Trail State Park. If you're like us and find tunnel building anything but boring, follow along in this video as we take an inside look at the geologic history of the tunnel site itself, exploring how the landscape affected the railroad and how the railroad affected the landscape, here on Ozark Outsider. In the early 1890s, the Missouri, Kansas, and Texas Railroad, nicknamed Katy for its initials, was building a new line down the Missouri River Valley toward St. Louis, but it encountered a unique challenge at the small town of Rocheport. On the east side of a ridge blocking its path, the railroad tunneled into a sheer rock face composed of limestone from what geologists call the Burlington Formation. The history of these rocks takes us back over 300 million years, to a time when what's now Missouri was covered in tropical seas. Evidence for this comes in the Burlington's locally abundant fossil deposits, such as those exposed in the cut just beyond the west portal. Here you can see beautiful crinoids and other signs of marine life. In this part of central Missouri, the Burlington limestone forms dramatic bluffs towering 200 feet above the river and the rail line. The railroad clearly decided the bedrock was reasonably stable here, as it cut a bare rock portal into the eastern bluff. But something interesting happens halfway through. The tunnel transitions from bare rock to a base of dressed limestone blocks holding up an arched brick ceiling. Why would the railroad go to all that fuss and expense for only half a tunnel? Near the bare rock eastern portal, we noticed some odd geological patterns. While most of the limestone here is pretty solid, there are a few places where the rock looks oddly chaotic, with some jumbled chunks of chert and limestone mixed in with small amounts of shale. And here's another example halfway into the tunnel. To the left is normal solid limestone, but between that and the stone blocks is another zone of jumbled material. These areas seem to form in clear pockets within the solid bedrock, and seem to be less cohesive than the normal limestone. Did the railroad encounter more of these zones further into the tunnel, forcing it to start the stone and brick liner deep beneath the ridge? We can't check this directly, but it's an interesting thought. Regardless, it's a reminder that parts of the tunnel area are somewhat unstable. So how did these features form? One possibility is that they represent old sinkholes or caves in the limestone that filled with rubble at a later geologic date, then was naturally cemented into place by mineralized groundwater. The Burlington is regionally known for its abundant caves and sinkholes, such as here at nearby Rockbridge State Park, and filled sinks aren't unusual in central Missouri or the Ozarks. It would be kind of ironic if a tunnel built to avoid unstable riverbank conditions ended up pushing through unstable bedrock conditions instead. Going back to the stone lining in the western half of the tunnel, you'd be forgiven for assuming that these limestone blocks were quarried locally. But a geologist's eye says that these don't look like the local limestone, and a really neat analysis by the Missouri Geological Survey of fossil assemblages in the blocks proved that they could only have come from one part of eastern Kansas. If that seems odd to you, consider that a well-established branch of the Katy ran through Emporia, a regional quarrying center. The local limestone is shot through with chert layers and other impurities, so apparently it made sense to ship in higher quality stone from a location already on the Katy system. Another explanation of the half-line tunnel relates to what's on top of the limestone. At the western portal, you can see that the landscape is very different. Instead of a sheer rock bluff, there are steep, tree-covered slopes with almost no rock showing. This is even clearer in a photograph taken during tunnel construction, when all those pesky trees were removed. You can see plenty of steep slopes, but where's the bedrock? To answer this, we need to jump back in geologic time again. A series of glacial advances reached this part of Missouri more than half a million years ago, bulldozing northern Missouri nearly flat and altering its river patterns. The modern Missouri River's route across the state loosely follows the rough southern extent of these glacial advances, and its wide, deep valley was probably carved by glacial meltwater. How cool is it that a railroad shortcut to St. Louis exists because of glacial activity hundreds of thousands of years ago? Glaciers themselves didn't reach Missouri during the most recent glacial period that ended around 11,000 years ago, but their effects continued to shape the landscape. Previous glaciations had left deposits of a particularly fine-grained sediment called loess along the Missouri River. Strong winds and a cold, dry climate carried and redeposited thick layers of this stuff over the hill country along the Missouri River corridor, including in the Rocheport area.
The west side of this bedrock ridge is clearly mantled in a thick deposit of loess. A geologist's eye can easily pick out the distinct steep slopes lacking any bedrock. And if you look carefully, you can actually see some loess exposed high above the railroad cut, with its distinctive yellowish coloration. So the railroad couldn't just blast straight through all of this loose sediment, but it had to make a deep cut and build a lined tunnel. And also had to knock back the hillside quite a bit to make the loess stable enough for that open cut. Notice all the mule carts hauling soil off this hill, and the various dump roads and stations for disposing of it? This is something to consider when hiking around the area. This ridge was significantly altered by the railroad, and there's very little natural about it. Today, you can still see the traces of these haul roads, and some of the dump sites. The amount of work and materials that Katy put into this tunnel stands in interesting contrast to the rest of the line. The St. Louis Extension was notoriously built fast and cheap, with many corners cut in the rush to completion. This would come back to haunt the railroad as the line became a maintenance nightmare, prone to frequent flood damage and other issues. It's even possible that the half-line tunnel relates to this low-budget approach. But what the Katy built here gives us a great inside look at the area's geologic history, and still fascinates visitors 130 years later.
And if you like railroad geology videos like this, let us know in the comments below, because there's a lot more stories like this in and around the Ozarks waiting to be told.